Today I'm going to talk to you about something called low dose naltrexone, or LDN. Now, naltrexone, in its sort of pharmaceutical standard use, is used usually in the emergency ward for people who are overdosing on something like heroin. And that's about 50 milligrams. And what that actually does is it blocks what's called an opiate receptor. And if you're taking high amounts of opiates and the receptor is blocked, then you're not going to basically go farther into the opiate experience. And it saves lots of lives that way. LDN is also used, or pardon me, naltrexone is also used for people who are suffering from alcoholism and other kinds of addiction, where you make the commitment that, you know, you get home from work or whatever, and you're going to take your naltrexone, usually around 50 milligrams, and for that next few hours, even if you were drinking, the kind of high or disinhibiting experience of alcohol wouldn't actually happen to you, which kind of makes the whole thing boring, and most people are just going to quit, and it's, you know, still hard on your body, but, you know, you're not having any fun. But that would still require that personal commitment to take the medication for that use. Now, when it comes to low-dose naltrexone, what we use that for mostly in medicine is for people with autoimmune conditions, and I'll get into kind of how that works. So most people are taking between 1.5 to 4.5 milligrams of naltrexone. And again, standard dose is, you know, 50. If you're taking 1.5, that's a really low dose. But it still has this interesting effect around blocking an opiate receptor. Now, you have opiate receptors all over the place in your brain, but especially in your immune system cells. So if you're taking your low dose naltrexone, and some people take it before bed, some people take it in the morning, the medication comes along and it blocks the opiate receptors all over the place, but specifically on your immune system cells. Now, your immune system cells don't like that very much because there are certain endorphins in your body that regulate kind of the military aspect of your immune system, you know, in the sense of if it's really, really upset or if it's really, really dormant. And with autoimmune conditions, your immune system is typically really, really upset. And for whatever reason, which I'll get into in another video, it's actually upset with some tissue in your body and it's causing this process of an illness to progress. So we take the low-dose naltrexone, the LDN, it blocks the receptor. The immune system cell sends out a message, a little molecule that says, where's the endorphins? Right? So your brain is going, oh, well, I guess we should secrete some more endorphins. So now your body starts to get this, it's a very small dose, but, subtle rush of endorphins in the body. And some people feel it, some people don't. And after about approximately 4 hours, the medication runs its course, and then you have this increase in endorphins that your brain and your immune system and your glands and stuff have been producing for the last 4 hours, and they're all circulating through your blood supply looking for a place to go. And now that the endorphin blocking effect of the drug has been diminished, all the endorphins go into these receptor sites, making your immune system feel kind of nurtured and loved and taken care of. And then the kind of messengers it sends to the rest of your immune system change, right? So the simplest way to put it would be there's what I call a traffic cop, we call TH1, another traffic cop called TH2, and then we have this other really healthy traffic cop we're going to call the regulatory traffic cop number 3. And regulatory means keeping it somewhere in the middle, you know, not too far to the left or the right. Depending on your condition, and I'll get into this in another video because it's kind of complicated, the illness process is either going to be run by an abundance of TH1 or an abundance of TH2. And, you know, everyone who talks about this, you know, we talk about how it's kind of like a teeter-totter or a seesaw. And, you know, if for whatever reason your immune system, your diet, the supplements you're taking are forcing this pathway to progress, then any illness that's due to that pathway or involved in that pathway will also progress. And the same is with the TH1 pathway. If your immune system, your diet, your supplements are pushing this pathway, then what you're going to see is that illness progress. But if we can basically kind of trick your immune system and the secretion of endorphins to produce a higher amount of the regulatory T3, the healthy traffic cop that takes you in the direction that you want to go instead of the direction that makes you sick in this way or sicker in that way, You see a lot of people, especially with Crohn's disease, MS, some degree fibromyalgia, arthritis, chronic fatigue syndrome. I don't know, the list is getting longer and longer pretty much every year, of illnesses that a simple amount of a pharmaceutical medication, and here I am being an integrative medicine doctor saying, well, there is a pharmaceutical that's actually good for you and may do something really, really helpful. Because in my opinion, most of them are kind of like band-aids, you know, they manage an illness, they don't actually do any real thorough healing, and that's usually up to us anyway. So, excuse me, LDN, if you take it every day, you're going to change how your immune system works with the endorphins in your body to produce a healthy regulatory immune system that is going to abate inflammation, it's going to reduce pain, reduce swelling, and allow your body to do more healing than dealing with basically tissue damage and the process of an illness. So give it some more research. If you have any questions, comments, put them in the little comment box below. Again, my name is Michael Smith. I'm an integrative medicine doctor. If you need any kind of help and you're looking for someone like me, I work with people all over the world, so you can contact me through my website. I'll put a link on the screen here. Computers are amazing. Please like and share this video so you can get this out there to anyone who you think might need this information. Please please subscribe to this channel. I'm trying to get a lot of this stuff out there, and I'm kind of new to YouTube and how it all works, but apparently more subscriptions, the more people will actually see this. So, you know, click the button and help everybody out. So, hope you're having a great day. Take care of yourself, cook well, eat well, and be well.